Hey there, it's Walt, and it's...
And it's Anne.
It's so nice to have you back
Thank
on the
you.
Blog.
Thank you.
You were looking at Facebook this morning.
One does for hours on end.
But you saw a memory that we had, and it was like, wow.
Yeah, we were up in Long's Peak in Colorado, and we were just hiking the mountains, and there was this bizarre bird that I took a picture of. And it was a great moment. It was a great memory. And it's like, hard to believe that a year has gone by since... We were in Colorado hiking Long's Peak.
Yeah, and how fast time does fly by, whether you're doing anything or not. You know, we were talking about this. My very favorite straight play, is Waiting for Godot, the Beckett play, Waiting for Godot. And it's a very, for those of you who haven't seen it, it's a very simple play. It's two characters on an empty stage for two straight acts, for almost two straight hours. And it's a dialogue back and forth between the two characters, and they're waiting for this other character, Godot. And there's some theory that maybe Godot is God, or we don't really know who this Godot is, but they're waiting, and Godot never comes.
All right, I've never seen Waiting for Godot. I hear it's a great play, but waiting around for two acts doesn't recommend itself. But you know, it's like waiting around for two acts, or waiting around for
what
your life to happen, doesn't particularly recommend, which reminds me of Donald Miller's book, 1,000 Miles in a Million Years, something
yes.
like that, where he realizes that he's not really lived a life, and that when it comes time to like make a movie out of some book he wrote, he had to go create a life because he hadn't actually done that. What he had done thus far, he bored him.
So that's what we've been talking about, is actually creating a life. You know, over the last 8 or 10 weeks, as you know, the quarantine has unfolded, we've actually seen two very distinct camps. On the one hand are many of the clients that we're so privileged to work with. They're digging down into their businesses, they're growing, they're scaling. Many of them are seeing double-digit increases year over year.
Yeah, some of my clients, they are on fire. For the first time in a long time, they've got the time and the space to be working on books. And I'm like, I can't even keep up with them. They are producing, and they are like, we need this out now, which is exciting.
So, you know, there are these two camps. On the one hand, the folks who are using this opportunity, these moments of our lives, to create, to co-create, to actually exponentially grow their businesses and get their messages out in the world. And
yeah,
then there's the other camp.
The Waiting for Godot camp. And, you know, not to put it down, like, everybody deals with stress in a different fashion. So no harm, no foul. But there is a group out there that they're just kind of waiting for life to get back to normal, and they're using this as a pause. And none of us knows if this is two acts of Waiting for Godot, or if it's like a little blip in time. So
it's really important for us to seize these moments. Annie Dillard has that wonderful quote, how we spend our days is in fact how we spend our lives. And if we're simply spending our days waiting and waiting and waiting for something, and not utilizing our gifts and talents, not using the moment to create or co-create something magnificent, we're allowing the time to go by. And just, you know, just like that year slid by since Long's Peak.
I can't even believe that.
This time will slide by, and it will be in the rearview mirror for good or for bad. We have an amazing moment in time. Every moment in time is the opportunity to begin again and to create again. And so don't wait. Seize this moment.
Don't stop waiting for Godot. Stop waiting for Godot.
Make it a great rest of the day, great rest of the week. Talk soon.
Bye, guys.